Okay, we have our main session of the week here, so make sure that we are well prepared going into this session, well hydrated, well fueled, after a good night's sleep, and ready to give this session everything you got. It's our last hard session before we integrate back into the skills program for most of you guys, so really, really important we tick this off and give it our maximum effort. We'll kick off with a easy 5-minute jog just to flush the body from Wednesday's session, then pick a couple of different change of direction drills than you've done in earlier in the week. Variation is key when it comes to change of direction. If you practice it in training, you'll have more options on game day. So really important that you practice different types of change of direction, whether you're turning around, staying in an athletic stance and shuffling side to side, or forwards and backwards pedaling, coming on and off the ground. So mix up the angles as best you can, and practicing cutting as well as quick steps. Then from here, 5 20-minute strides just to prepare you for the intensity later on in the session. So focus on your technique, your acceleration technique on those ones. And then from there, we start off with 2 3-minute efforts with 3 minutes rest in between, really trying to push this one. So focus on holding a solid pace and finishing the reps strong. So pick up the pace. Whether you have 400 meters left, 300 meters, 200, wherever it is, pick your moment and finish strong. And we want to try and get above 1K for each effort. Then we'll go into a football circuit. If you hit the attachment button, you'll be able to see a good visual here, which just easily demonstrates what we're doing. So running around the footy ground, and you just don't have to set out cones or anything like that, but you're just mixing it up. So weaving in and out of the goal square, the goal post, then into a sprint to the 50 meter, then stride it out into a jog, walk, and then repeat. So we got one of those. Then we're in and get the footballs involved with that as well. So you're bouncing the footy when you're jogging, mix up different hands, and you're doing a two-hand touch ball with when you're running, and then with the sprint, try and hold it, touch it to close to the chest in one arm. And see if you can bounce while sprinting as well. Then from there, we've got our 10 200-meter efforts with the A's trying to hit 35 to 37-second reps. So you're getting over 20 seconds rest between each effort. Obviously running on the minute. So every minute on the minute you go, you run your 200s and have your targets that you're trying to hit. Consistency is key here. So we don't want to try and hit sprinting reps. We just want to hit consistent threshold pace reps here. Then after a good rest, we're into our 3 kick-to-goal drill. So focusing on some longer kicks and then chasing the ball down with a hard effort, regathering and kicking long again. So some longer efforts just to condition our quads. We've got a total of 10, 5 up and 5 back. And try using your alternate foots per trip as well, so you're getting exposure to both legs. Some goal kicking, particularly also practicing some longer efforts under for some fatigue. And then we're done. Thanks, guys. If you have any questions or queries, hit me up on the app. We'll also have one more session, remember, as well to do tomorrow. No doubt you'll be fatigued and heavy from the week. We wanted to get 4 sessions in this week just to give ourselves every chance to perform well at testing when we come back, as well as just to build our resilience for our body to handle the loads to come during January and February.